Donald Trump's closest friends and allies are, I guess you would call it, collectively losing their minds right now. They're doing everything possible and digging as deep into that conspiracy theory well as humanly possible to convince the public that Donald Trump had the election stolen from right under his nose. The latest is convicted felon Roger Stone, who appeared on the Alex Jones program earlier this week, where he laid out what might be the most bizarre conspiracy theory related to election theft. And keep in mind, we have already had a conspiracy theory that Hugo Chavez's ghost somehow conspired with George Soros and the Clinton Foundation and communists from Serbia to steal the election. Roger Stone may have outdone all of that. Here's what he said, word for word from Roger Stone. I just learned of absolute incontrovertible evidence of North Korean boats delivering ballots through a harbor in Maine, the state of Maine. If this checks out, if law enforcement looked into that and it turned out to be true, it would be proof of foreign involvement in the election. Has Roger Stone ever seen a map? I'm just wondering. I mean, let's say for a moment North Korea did this. Do you know where North Korea is? Do you know that there is essentially an entire continent? No matter which way you go, there's several continents. But there is at minimum one full continent in between North Korea and the state of Maine. And that continent is obviously North America. So for this conspiracy theory to work out, North Korea would have to send a boat. They'd have to travel down the Pacific. And now you think, oh, well, they go through the Panama Canal. But no, folks, you have to be covert. Everything that goes through the Panama Canal is documented and checked, and you have to pay a fee. So no, they would not go through the Panama Canal. They would, in fact, have to go all the way around the southern tip of South America. So now they are circumventing two continents. And then you go into the Atlantic and all the way up the coast of South America, the coast of North America, you know, past countless military ships, military bases that we keep on the shores there, all the way up to the tip top of Maine, where you get out of the boat and you say, here's your fake ballots. I gotta go. Long trip. Yeah. They're not even trying with these conspiracy theories anymore, to be honest, folks. For real, North Korea is friends with Donald Trump. They want him in office. They would not send a boat thousands and thousands and thousands of miles out of the way to deliver counterfeit ballots to Maine. Maine of all places. Come on, Roger. You could have said that they had an Antifa boat waiting up in Seattle, you know, right there in the harbor. Oh, and then Antifa, you know, met with the North Koreans out there at sea. And then they sent the documents. I mean, come on. There's much more plausible ways to make that particular conspiracy theory work while still using all of the conservative buzzwords. You know, at least Sidney Powell had the buzzwords in there, you know. Hugo Chavez, George Soros, Clinton Foundation, communist, China. You're not even trying, Roger. Is that what prison does to you? Makes it where you just can't even come up with a cogent conspiracy theory anymore. Whatever the case, we are watching in real time as all of Donald Trump's friends collectively go insane. And these are the best and brightest that he has defending him. So keep in mind, folks, if you're watching this and you still happen to be a Trump supporter, those are the people on your side. And that is how their brain works. Is that really what you want to be associated with? May want to think long and hard about that one.